Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're covering the Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila, and we're on chapter 15.
我们这一天讲的是《Chaitanya Charitamrita》中篇逍遥，中期逍遥第十五章的内容。
Lord Chaitanya is saying goodbye to the devotees from Bengal because they'd all come to Jagannath Puri to visit him, and they stayed for 4 months of the Chaturmasya, and after the Chaturmasya they'll get ready to go back to Bengal.
孟加拉的奉献者们来到哥纳库里待了四个月，然后在Chaturmasya四月苦行之后呢，他们又准备返回孟加拉了。So
Lord Chaitanya wants to give them instructions, some instructions before they go.
所以在他们返回孟加拉之前，Chaitanya就希望给他们一些教导。But
there were two devotees. They came to Lord Chaitanya and they had a question. They asked Lord Chaitanya.
但是有两位奉献者呢，他们就来找到Chaitanya，向他提出了问题。
And they said, you know, they said, we are householders and we're materialistic people. We don't know the process of advancing in spiritual life.
他们就坦言说，我们都是物质主义的居士，我们想知道在灵性生活当中进步的方法是什么。So
Lord Chaitanya told them, you have to constantly chant the holy name, and wherever possible, you should serve the Vaishnavas.
Chaitanya 就告诉这两位Vaishnava说， 你们应当常常的唱诵正名，而且一旦有可能的话，应当去服务Vaishnava们。So
when the devotees heard this, the two devotees, they asked him, they asked Lord Chaitanya, how can we recognize who is a Vaishnava?
两位奉献者听了这番回答之后，就又问道，我们怎么能认出谁是一位Vaishnava呢？
So Lord Chaitanya replied, whoever chants the holy name of Krishna, even just once, is worshipable, and he is the best of human beings.
不查丹娘回答说，无论谁，即便是只是吟诵了Krishna的圣名一次，那么这样的人也是值得崇拜的，他也是人类当中的佼佼者。
Then Lord Chaitanya went on to explain. He said, just by chanting the holy name of Krishna once, a person can be freed from all the reactions of his sins.
Chaitanya 继续解释说道，倘若仅仅唱诵Krishna的圣名一次，这个人就能摆脱所有罪恶生活的反应了。
So this has to be understood carefully.
所以要小心的来理解这句话。
It means that if you may just chant one time, but you have to chant without any offenses. You have to chant the pure name, and then you get free from all sinful reactions.
意思就是说， 即便唱诵一次，但是这一次的念诵必须是没有冒犯的，并且是唱诵了纯粹的圣名，这样才可以摆脱所有的罪恶反应。There
are 9 processes of devotional service.
奉献服务有九种。
We know, beginning with hearing and chanting and remembering.
第九种奉献服务始于聆听、放送和意念。
And then offering prayers, and then worshipping the deity.
供奉祷文，崇拜神像。
Serving the lotus feet of the Lord.
服务主的莲花足。
Being the friend of the Lord.
与主为友。
Giving service to the Lord.
服务主。
And surrendering everything to Him.
将一切臣服给他。
So these are the 9 items of devotional service, and that's it. That's the topmost level. That's the perfection of life, to be able to engage in these activities.
便是九项奉献服务，能够从事这些活动，人生就达到了完美境界了。
And just by chanting the holy name, we can engage in these activities. 哈里波 ，Guru Mani。Guru Mani?
Hare Krishna Gurudev,
yeah.
他可能掉线了，我们等他一下。
北京有掉线。
北京也掉线了。
我们也有掉线吗？
我们这里还好，他是掉线了。他现在正在 重新登录。
OK。
OK。Guru Mani Mataji, 我已经把你设为主持人了，你现在可以开麦了。
好的。Sorry, 不知道为什么我的电脑突然就死机了。Okay. Sorry, my computer suddenly shut up, I don't know why.
Okay.
Yes, just now you mentioned that the,just by chanting the holy name, that one can engage in all these 9 devotional series.
Yes.
刚才Guru 就讲到，仅仅是通过唱诵圣名，人就可以来从事这九项奉献服务了。
And one time chanting the holy name can destroy all of our sinful reactions.
而且是只有即便是唱诵圣名一遍，也可以摧毁我们所有的罪恶反应。
But we have to chant the holy name without any offense.
但是前提是我们必须是毫无没有冒犯的来唱诵这一遍圣名。
Anybody who can chant the holy name without offense, he's very great devotee, and we should worship him.
任何人能够没有冒犯的唱诵圣名。那么他是一个伟大的奉献者，我们应该崇拜他。
And when we chant the holy name without offense, then we can perform all these 9 activities of devotional service.
当我们没有冒犯的唱诵圣名的时候，就可以从事这九项奉爱服务了。
So of the 9 processes of devotional service, kirtan is very important.
在这9项奉爱服务当中, kirtan 是非常重要的。
Now other processes like offering prayers and worshipping the deity and serving and being the friend, they should also be done.
其他的奉献服务,例如向主献上祈祷,服务主,与主为友,这些服务也都要去做。
But they should be, before we do them, we should do kirtan, and when we, after we do them, after we complete performing these activities, then again we should do kirtan.
但是在做这些服务之前, 我们要进行 kirtan, 在完成这些服务之后, 也要进行 kirtan.
Just like in our temples, we always have we have arti and we have offerings and dressing the deities. So all these activities, before we do them and after we do them, there's kirtan. There's always chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra.
就像在庙宇当中，当我们做了阿提灯仪，供奉，在做这些活动之前呢，我们要做阿提，而且等，sorry，在做他们之前，我们要kirtan，在之后我们也要kirtan。
Yeah, kirtan can be giving class, that's also kirtan. It's not necessary you have to give kirtan with madanga and kartals, but you give a class, you have a class, that's also kirtan.
Kirtan 并不单纯地意味着叫演奏 mridangjagu 或是打脑鼓, 这叫kirtan, 讲课也属于kirtan.
Just to speak the glories of the Lord, that is kirtan.
仅仅是讲述主的荣耀, 这就是kirtan.
Discussing topics of Krishna, that is kirtan.
讨论有关 Krishna的话题也算作是kirtan.
We're having a lot of kirtan this week. We're having the, all these classes, this is all kirtan.
我们这一周就做了许许多多的kirtan，因为我们这一周讲了很多的课程，这都是，这就算作是kirtan。
Okay, now we're going to go on. There's a very important text coming up in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Everyone should take a note of it. It's text number 108, 108 in the 15th chapter of Madhya Lila.
好,接下来呢,我们要讲述的这个诗节是非常重要的诗节,每个人都应该拿出纸和笔来做笔记。这个诗节是Chaitanya
Lord Chaitanya is instructing these two devotees who had asked him about how to make advancement. Two devotees said, we're householders, we're very materialistic, how can we progress?
两位奉献者就谦卑地说,我们都是居士,我们特别的物质化,然而我们怎么取得进步呢?
And Lord Chaitanya said, you have to constantly chant the holy name and you should take all, do whatever, take every opportunity you can to give service to the devotees.
就柴丹亚就教导他们,你们应当常常地唱诵圣名。
So then they asked how to recognize the devotee, and Lord Chaitanya said, anybody who chants the holy name even one time, he's a devotee.
紧接着两位奉献者又问,我们怎么才能认出谁是奉献者呢?如柴丹亚就说,这个人倘若只唱诵一遍Krishna的名字,就能够算作是奉献者了。
So now Lord Chaitanya is describing more about how to recognize a devotee.
接下来呢, 主柴丹亚就更进一步来指出, 如何认出谁是奉献者。
He said, one does not have to take initiation.
就柴德尼亚说，一个人无需一定要经过启迪。
And he doesn't have to perform all the activities which are required before initiation.
而且这个人也无需一定要去执行在启迪之前去执行所有那些所需要的活动。
He only has to chant the holy name with his lips.
他只需要用他的唇齿来发出圣灵的音阵。
Then even a man in the lowest class, if it's in the lowest social position, he can be delivered.
那么即便是一个 处在最低级的社会地位上的人也可以得到救赎了。
So some people, they read this verse and they think, oh, I don't need to get initiated. I just have to chant the holy name.
有的人读到了这个诗节了，然后他就感到松了口气，说：“哦，那我就不用起立了，我就唱诵圣名就好了。”
But you cannot just chant the holy name. You will do so many other things besides chant the holy name.
但是，您并不是总在唱诵圣名，除了唱圣名之外，您还在做着其他的事儿。
You're going to want to, sometimes you will want to read the scriptures.
有的时候呢，也想去读读经典。
Sometimes you will want to do cooking and worship the deity.
有的时候您也想为主做饭或者是崇拜神像。
We cannot imitate Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur, he could just chant the holy name.
我们不能单纯的模仿哈尔达斯塔库，哈尔达斯塔库是可以，只是在那唱诵圣名。
He was chanting every day three lakhs names every day.
哈尔达斯塔库每天都吟诵一唱圣名三十万遍。
So it would take practically more than 20 hours every day.
那几乎是每天要花。
Because three like names means 192 rounds.
30,000遍圣名就相当于192圈。
That's like 3 times 64.
就是3×64圈。
So if you've chanted 64 rounds in.Usually, it will, to chant 64 rounds, it will take at least 6 hours to chant.
一般而言呢，唱诵六十四圈，至少要花六个小时的时间。
To chant 16 rounds, we need about 2 hours.
因为要念诵16圈，我们需要2个小时的时间。
So to chant 64 rounds, we will need.Four times that. We'll need 8 hours.
那么如果要念诵六十四圈的话，那么就要2×4，就8个小时。
And so you're going to chant. That's 1 lakh. That's 64 rounds. But we want to chant 192 rounds. So you need the whole day to chant.
所以六十四圈呢，就是10万遍圣名。那么他念诵192圈，几乎就是花了一整天的时间。
So not easy to do that kind of thing, to just chant the holy name. We cannot imitate Haridas Thakur.
所以这么做可不容易，我们可不能模仿哈尔达斯塔库。
Haridas Thakur didn't need initiation because he just chanted the holy name.
Haridas Thakur 不需要起立，因为他只是仅仅是唱诵圣名。
But we're following Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada tells us we won't be able to do that kind of thing. We cannot just simply sit and chant the holy name. So he told us we should preach. And if we're going to preach, then people will ask you, who's your guru? And you say, no, I don't have a guru, I'm just chanting the holy name, I'm not initiated. But you're going preaching. That means you're not just chanting the holy name. And if you're going to worship the deity, you need to be initiated. So, there, and also there will be many times when we need guidance from a spiritual teacher. So, we see initiation as an important part of devotional service. So here Lord Chaitanya is describing a very special situation. So somebody is just chanting the holy name, they're not doing anything else. So then they don't need a guru. But they're very, very, it's very rare that anybody can do that. So although the verse says you don't need the guru, in the purport, Srila Prabhupada explains a lot about diksha. He says, initiation is the process by which we awaken transcendental knowledge. And we can get rid of all the reactions of our sinful activities. So the process of initiation is it says that even one may be born in a Brahmana family, but he cannot do Vedic rituals without being initiated.
接下来又说到，即便一个人是诞生在婆罗门家庭当中，但是他也如果，if he want to do Vedic ritual，OK，那如果他要举行韦达仪式的话，他是需要启迪的。Yeah,
he may be born in a Brahmana family, but he only becomes a Brahmana after initiation.
虽然一个人他出生是在婆罗门家庭，但是他只有经过启迪之后，他才能有婆罗门的资格，正式成为婆罗门。And
unless you're initiated as a Brahmin, you cannot worship the holy name properly.
而且除非一个人经过启迪成为了婆罗门，否则的话是不能正确的来崇拜圣名的。That's
a statement from the scriptures.
这是来自经典的论断。And
then, it also says one must be initiated. One should be initiated, unless one is initiated by a spiritual master, all of his devotional activities are useless.
接下来这句话是说。 除非一个人被一位正宗的灵魂导师启迪，否则的话，他所有的奉爱服务都是无用的。
The idea is the activities we do before initiation, they're helping to prepare us for initiation.
这个要点就是说，我们在启迪之前所从事的活动是让我们为启迪做好准备。
So they're not useless if we get initiation. But if we don't get initiation, then it's useless.
所以这些活动呢也并不是没有用的。但是如果我们最终没有启迪的话，那么这些活动就没有用了。
If a person is not properly initiated, then he can fall into the animal species.
如果一个人没有得到恰当的启迪的话，那么他有可能堕入到动物的种族当中。
So then it states also, it's the duty of every human to surrender to a guru.
接下来这句经典是每一个人类的职责就是向臣服一位真正的灵性导师 guru。
We should take Vaishnava initiation from him.
我们应当从他那里接受 Vaishnava 的启迪。
Just like, there's another famous verse that said, just like bell metal can be turned into gold when it's touched by mercury.
那接下来的这句经典说的是，就像青铜跟汞、银汞混合之后，可以转变成黄金。
Just like when a person is properly initiated, then he can get all the qualities of a brahmana.
当一个人得到恰当启迪之后，他就能够获得婆罗门的资格。
So in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, we should worship the deity and chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
在清晨、下午、傍晚，我们应当崇拜神像，唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
And we should perform a fire sacrifice and offer oblations, and then feed the brahmanas.
我们应当从事举行火祭。做供奉，然后给婆罗门喂养婆罗门。
So these five activities they help to prepare us for initiation.
那么这五项活动可以让我们做好准备，得到启迪。
Before we take initiation from the guru, we should first do these activities.
在我们得到灵性导师启迪之前，我们应当从事这些活动。
Just like in our Krishna consciousness, we don't immediately give people initiation.
就像在我们 Krishna 知觉运动当中，我们不会上来一立刻就给一个人启迪。
Anybody who wants initiation, then for 6 months they have to attend arti and classes.
任何希望启迪的人必须有6个月的时间参加灯仪 RT 并且听讲课。
Now they have to practice the regulative principles and stay in the association of devotees.
他们也必须遵守规范原则，并且与奉献者们联谊。
And then he can be recommended by the temple president for initiation.
接下来他可以得到庙长的推荐来获得启迪。
And Prabhupada said, it's not that anybody can be suddenly initiated.
圣帕帕德在要旨当中说到，任何人不能够忽然之间就得到启迪。
They have to be qualified and they have to be prepared for initiation.
他们必须具备资格，必须做好准备。
So when they chant 16 rounds every day and follow the regulative principles and attend the classes, then after 6 months, they can be recommended for initiation.
那么当这样的人，他们每天念诵 Hare Krishna mantra 16圈，遵守了规范原则，并且听了讲课，那么他可以在经过6个月之后得到启迪。
So there were five activities which are mentioned which are supposed to be done before initiation.
我们刚才讲到了在启迪之前一个人他可以从事五项活动。
So if we don't perform these activities, then it's difficult, it will be very difficult for us to chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
如果我们不从事这些活动的话那么唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 就比较困难。
But if we have followed these five principles, if we've done these five activities, then it's very easy for us.
但是倘若我们从事了这五项活动的话那么就很容易做到了。
Yeah, then, but we have to prepare ourselves for the initiation.
所以我们必须要为启迪做好充分的准备。
So these five activities, they are the life force which help us to be successful in chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
那么这五项活动是帮助我们在唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 的时候取得成功的生命原动力。
Without the life force, we cannot do anything. Haribo?
Haribo, yes.
If we,
yes,
without the life force, we're not able to do anything. In the body, if there's no life force, we cannot do anything with our body.
没有生命力的话，那么仅仅是有躯体，那么这个躯体也什么都做不了。
In the same way, if we don't do these five activities, hearing the scriptures and associating with the brahmanas and fire sacrifice and offering oblations. If we don't do these things, then we won't be able to chant the mantra perfectly.
就是这些活动包括聆听经典与婆罗门联谊做火祭供奉祭品倘若不做这些活动的话我们不能完美的唱诵 mantra。
Five activities, right. Worship the deity, chant Hare Krishna mantra, offer obeisances, offer oblations, fire sacrifice, and feed the brahmanas.
这五项活动就是分别是崇拜神像唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 供奉贡品举行火祭还有给婆罗门喂食喂养婆罗门
And Jiva Goswami tells us that it's very important to worship the deity
Jiva Goswami 就告诉我们崇拜神像的重要性
Sometimes in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it says that deity worship is not actually important.
在圣典博迦瓦兰有的地方说，崇拜神像实际上并不是很重要。
And just like in some scriptures, in some other scriptures, they say.Different things. They say, oh, you don't have to do that. You don't have to do this.
不同的经典就有不同的论断。他们说这件事是不需要做的，那件事不需要做。
But the Bhagavatam says, even without worshipping the deity, you can get success in the human life.
圣典博迦瓦坛说，即便是不去崇拜神像，人也可以达到人体生命的成功。
You just do any one of the other processes of devotional service.
你只需要从事奉献服务当中的任何一种。
But we follow the teachings of Narada Muni.
我们追随 Narada Muni 的教导。
Narada Muni and all the devotees who follow Narada Muni, they all worship the deity.
Narada Muni 以及 Narada Muni 的追随者们，他们都是崇拜神像的。
And by the grace of Narada Muni, they get initiation and they begin to worship the deity.
随着 Narada Muni 的仁慈，他们得到启迪，继而开始崇拜神像。
So it may appear deity worship is not essential, but actually it's required.
虽然表面上看神像崇拜并不是至关重要的，但是神像崇拜是需要的。
Because most of us, we're not very pure, we're conditioned by the material energy.And we need to do service for the deity. If we look at our body condition, our physical condition, and our mental condition, we see we're not very pure.And our minds are agitated.
而且我们心意总是躁动不安。
So to help us get over this conditioning, we have to worship the deity.
所以为了帮助我们克服这些状态，我们必须要崇拜神像。
Even though we may not be initiated, we can still get perfection.In devotional service, simply by chanting the holy name.
即便没有得到启迪，一个人也可以通过唱诵主的圣名达到完美，奉献服务的完美。
So chanting Hare Krishna is very powerful. Doesn't depend on initiation.
所以唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 是如此有力量。它并不依赖于正式的启迪。
But if we are initiated, then it's an advantage to us.
但是如果倘若我们被启迪的话，那么对我们来说是一个非常有利的条件和情况。
And if we do deity worship, then it will help us to awaken our Krishna consciousness.
而且如果我们从事神像崇拜的话，能够帮助我们唤醒我们的 Krishna 知觉。
And this will help us to get out of the material world.
这就能够帮助我们摆脱脱离这个物质世界。
So the more we can get free of material identification, the easier it will be for us to advance.
我们越是能够摆脱这种物质的认同，就越能容易地取得进步。
We will be able to understand that the spirit soul has the same qualities as the supreme soul.
我们就能够认识到灵性，灵魂和至尊灵魂拥有同样的品质。
Just like the holy name of the Lord and the Lord Himself are the same.
就像主的圣名和主本人是同一个。
So at that time, Hare Krishna mantra cannot be compared to any material sound.
所以在那个时候 ，Hare Krishna mantra 是不能和任何物质的音振相提并论的。
If we think Maha mantra is a material vibration, then we are fallen.
倘若我们认为 Hare Krishna mantra 是这物质的音振的话，那我们是堕落的。
We should worship and we should chant the holy name.
我们应当崇拜圣名，我们应当唱诵圣名。
And we should accept the holy name as Krishna himself.
并且我们应当把圣名当作主本人。
So that's another reason why should we have to be initiated properly according to the scriptures.
所以正是由于这个原因，我们应当得到恰当，根据启示经典受到恰当的启迪。
Chanting the holy name is good for both people, both the conditioned soul and the liberated soul.
唱诵圣名对于受条件限制的灵魂和解脱了的灵魂都有好处。
But it is especially good is very helpful for the conditioned souls.
但是对于受条件限制的灵魂而言是尤其的大有益处，而且特别有帮助。
Because by chanting the holy name, these conditioned souls can become liberated souls.
因为通过唱诵圣名，受条件限制的灵魂就能变成解脱的灵魂。
And he can go back home, back to Godhead.
如此一来，他便能回归家园，回归神手。
Yeah, but just by chanting the holy name, we can get free from the material existence.
仅仅通过唱诵圣名，我们就能摆脱物质的存在。
And simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, we'll be able to see the lotus feet of Krishna.
仅仅通过唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra, 一个人就能见到主的莲花足。
Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Krishna mantra haite habe samsara mochana.Krishna nama haite pabe Krishnara charana. Right? Simply by chanting the holy name of the Lord, we'll be able to see the lotus feet of Krishna.
仅仅通过唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，我们就能见到主的莲花足。
Who wants to see the lotus feet of Krishna? Everyone?
谁想见有没有人在场的有谁想要看到主的莲花足
？Then you have to be initiated.
那么你就必须得到启迪了。
And you have to chant the holy name under the direction of the spiritual master.
那么您就需要在灵性导师的指引之下唱诵圣名。
But offensive chanting does not depend on the initiation.
Offenseless.
Chanting without offenses, it doesn't mean that you have to be initiated before you can chant without offenses.
Okay. 那么没有冒犯的唱诵圣名并不依赖启迪。换句话说，并不是说你只有启迪了，你才能没有冒犯的唱诵圣名。
Initiation may depend on doing these activities. Before we get initiation, you have to do all these activities, we said, like worshipping the deity, chanting the holy name, feed the brahmanas.
我们刚才说到了，那么在启迪之前呢，人应当从事这些活动，比如说，崇拜、唱诵圣名、崇拜神像。
But the chanting of the holy name doesn't depend on these activities.
但是唱诵圣名是不依赖这些活动的。
If somebody can chant the holy name even once without offense, then he's very great. He gets all success.
倘若一个人可以没有冒犯的唱诵圣名，那么这个人是非常了不起的，他就能真达完美，真达成功。
But if you're going to chant the holy name without offense, you have to use your tongue. The tongue has to work.
但是，倘若你要是没有冒犯的唱诵圣名，那么必须要运用舌头，舌头必须要工作。
The tongue has to do service by chanting the holy name.
舌头必须要从事服务，通过唱诵圣名来
If our time is busy in tasting material things and talking about material things, then we cannot use the tongue for spiritual advancement. We cannot understand the holy name of Krishna just by our material senses. But when we engage in devotional service using the tongue, then Krishna reveals himself to us. So you can see how Srila Prabhupada explains the importance of initiation in this section. Just by chanting the holy name, we can get free from our entanglement in material activities. Then we become attracted to Krishna. Then our love for Krishna will awaken. So the holy name of Krishna is very attractive for all the saintly people. It's available for everyone. Everyone can chant, even the lowest of people. When somebody chants the holy name with the tongue, immediately effects are produced. And chanting the holy name doesn't depend on initiation or pious activities. The holy name doesn't wait for any of these activities. The holy name is self-sufficient. So then Lord Chaitanya said, anybody who is chanting the Hare Krishna mantra is understood to be a Vaishnava. You should offer all respects to him. In the Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami describes how to relate to different levels of devotees. He said, we should mentally honor a devotee who chants the holy name, anyone who chants the holy name. And if somebody is engaged in worshipping the deity and has had spiritual initiation, we should offer obeisances to him.
而有的人他已经得到了启迪，并且正在崇拜，已经崇拜神像了。那我们应当向他致以顶礼。
But we should associate with and serve the devotee who is fixed in undeviating devotional service and does not criticize anyone.
我们应当联谊，我们应当与那些毫不分心的从事于奉爱服务，并且摆脱了任何批评倾向的奉献者联谊，并且服务他们。
So somebody may be an advanced devotee, he should respect any devotee who has been initiated by a guru.
假如一个人已经是进步了奉献者的话，那么他们应该尊敬任何一位得到guru启迪的奉献者。
And we should see him as being situated on the transcendental platform.
我们应当把他视作处在了超然层面上。
Because he's chanting the holy name, and he's offering obeisances, and he's following the instructions of his guru. So we should respect him.
因为他唱诵圣名，他也顶拜，他也遵守了guru的训示，所以我们应当尊敬他。
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur says it's very important for householders to serve the Vaishnavas.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 说服务 Vaishnava 对于居士而言是非常重要的。
And he said it doesn't matter if the Vaishnava is initiated or not.
并且他还说无论这位Vaishnava到底 是不是已经启迪了,
Somebody may be initiated, but they may still be contaminated with Mayavadi philosophy.
有的人也许已经得到了启迪，但是仍然被Mayavadi假象中哲学污染。
But somebody else may be chanting the holy name without offenses, and he won't be so contaminated.
另外一方面，倘若有人们 没有冒犯的唱诵了圣名的话，那么他们就没有受到这个妈妈的污染。Somebody
may be they may be initiated as a Vaishnava, but they may not. Of course, this doesn't mean they're perfect.
当然，并不是说一个 Vaishnava 得到启迪了，他就已经完美了。But
anybody who is chanting the holy name without offenses, he is perfect.
但是任何人倘若能够没有冒犯地唱诵了主的圣名，那么这个人就是完美了的。He
may appear to be like a neophyte, but still he should be considered a pure devotee.
表面上看他可能视为出席的奉献者，但是他仍然应当被视为是一个纯洁无瑕的
So it's a duty of the householders to offer respect to all these devotees.
作为居士就有责任向这样的奉献者致以全部的敬意。
This was Lord Chaitanya's instruction to these devotees.
这便是主Chaitanya对这两位奉献者的教导。
So after Lord Chaitanya had given instruction to these people, then he turned to some other devotees. He wants to give them instruction. So there were three people from the village called Kanda.
有三位来自康达这个地方的人。
So they're very wonderful devotees. One was called Mukunda, one was called Raghunandan, and the other was called Sri Narahari. Now, actually, Mukunda was the father of Raghunandan.
实际上，Mukunda是Raghunanda的父亲。And
Narahari was like the brother of Mukunda.
而Narahari就好像Mukunda的兄弟。So
Lord Chaitanya said to Mukunda, he said, are you the father and your son is Raghunandan? Is that true?
所以主柴丹尼亚就对对母昆的对母昆的说 Raghunanda 是你的父亲还是你是
Raghunanda 是你的儿子还是你是他的父亲吗？ Raghunanda 是不是他的你的儿子？是不是这样？
嗯。
Or is Raghunanda your father and you are his son?
还是 Raghunanda 是你的爸爸，然后你是他的儿子呢？
Tell me the truth.
请告诉我真相。
I have doubts about this.
我对此心存疑虑。
Now, actually, Mukunda was the father of Raghunanda.
实际上 Mukunda 是 Raghunanda 的爸爸。
But Mukunda said, Raghunanda is my father, and I am his son. This is my decision.
但是 Mukunda 回答说 Raghunanda 是我的爸爸，我是他的儿子，这是我的决定。
All of us have attained devotion to Krishna due to Raghunanda. All of our family have become devotees to Krishna by Raghunanda's influence. We
are all because
of Raghunanda's influence. So in my mind, Raghunanda is my father.
So in my mind, Raghunanda is my father.
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, he said, yes, this is right. That the person who helps, who awakens you to Krishna is certainly like your spiritual teacher.
谁若是倘若帮助你唤醒了对 Krishna 的奉爱，那么
So Lord Chaitanya was very happy to speak about these wonderful devotees and their wonderful qualities.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 谈到奉献者美妙的荣耀和品质的时候，他变得非常的愉悦。
So Lord Chaitanya told all the devotees, he said, "Let me tell you about Mukunda's love for Krishna."
接着主柴丹尼亚又对所有的奉献者说现在请听我来描述穆昆的对神手的奉爱
His love for Krishna is very deep and pure
穆昆的对神手的爱非常的深厚和纯粹
It's like purified gold
那就好像是已经纯化了的黄金
So Mukunda, Lord Chaitanya is telling the story, he said, Mukunda, in his external, in his ordinary life, he appears to be like he's a doctor in the service of the king.
So, Lord Chaitanya 就讲一个故事，就说 Mukunda 就在日常活动当中呢，好像是国王的一位皇家的御医。
But actually, in his heart, Mukunda has a very deep love for Krishna.
在他的内心，他对 Krishna 怀着深厚的爱。
So Lord Chaitanya is actually showing us that we cannot understand who is actually a great devotee of Krishna.
所以实际上，主柴丹尼亚就像我们。表明就我们不能够明白到底谁是主的纯粹奉献者。
Just like this Mukunda, he was working in the government service as a doctor.
就像这位 Mukunda, 他的职位呢是一个政府当中的一个医生。
But at the same time, in his heart, he's an eternally liberated devotee.
可是在他的内心他是一个永恒解脱的奉献者。
Externally, he's a doctor for the royal court for the king, the ruler, but internally he's a Paramahansa devotee.
外在的他是这位这个国王的皇家的医生，但是他的内心是一位至尊天鹅的奉献者。So
Lord Chaitanya knew this, but ordinary man could not understand it.
如柴坦尼亚很了解这点，但是普通人不能明白。Ordinary
people cannot understand the dealings of the Vaishnavas.
普通人不能够理解Vaishnava的日常活动。But
Lord Chaitanya, he can understand everything about the devotees.
但是主柴坦尼亚对奉献者的方方面面都一清二楚。
Even though externally they may appear to be like ordinary householders and they're businessmen or professionals, but they can understand the real heart of the person.
即便这些奉献者表面上好像是普通的居士，或者是普通的生意人，或者是职场上的人，但是他们的内心却是奉献者。So
one day Mukunda was sitting beside the Muslim king. The king was a Muslim and Mukunda was the doctor, and he was sitting beside the king and he was telling the king about a medical treatment, about how he was going to treat the king.
有一天呢，穆昆达他和这位穆斯林国王就坐在一个地方，在给这国王就讲解这个医，就是给他治疗的这种方法。So
when the king was talking with Mukunda, then the servant of the king, he brought a big fan made of peacock feathers to shade the king's head from the sun.
当国王和穆昆达就这样交流的时候呢，一位仆人就拿了一个孔雀羽毛扇子来。
And he held the fan above the head of the king. And when Mukunda saw the peacock fan, it awakened his love for Krishna, and he fell. He fell on the ground.
当穆昆达一看见这个孔雀羽毛扇的话， 他内心的神脉就唤醒了，然后他就倒在了地上。He
was on a high platform because he was talking to the king, but he fell off the high platform, fell on the ground.
穆昆达和国王呢坐在一个就是高出地面的一个平台上，但是他就从这个台子上摔了下去，倒在了地板上。
So the king was worried that maybe something has happened to him, and so he got off the throne and he came down to try to take care of Mukunda. So the king said to the Mukunda, he said, Where is the pain? Where is your pain?
国王问穆昆达，你哪里疼了？
And Mukunda said, No, I don't have any pain. I'm okay.
穆昆达说，我没有疼痛，我没有事。
So the king asked, he said, Well, what happened? Why did you fall down?
国王就很关切地问，到底发生了什么事情？
So Mukunda says, "Oh, my dear king, I have a disease called epilepsy. Epilepsy. You know that disease? You know, if there's a lot of noise, sometimes then they will upset people. They go crazy. You know, they become hysterical." They collapse, they just fall down. people who have this disease, they can't drive or anything?
Let me first check the...
EPI.
Okay.
What's the disease?
Dian xian.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right, that's right.
你跟着就回答国王说, 我有一种病, 我患了癫痫病。
So, but the king was very intelligent and he could understand.
但是国王特别的聪明, 他就能够明白到底是怎么回事。
And he understood that Mukunda was actually a very liberated, he was a great soul, he was a liberated person.
国王就知道，Mukunda是一个了不起的解脱的灵魂了。So,
the son of Mukunda is Raghunandan, and he's always engaged in serving the deity of Lord Krishna in the temple.
Mukunda's son Raghunandan, 他是恒常的。
And beside the entrance to the temple, there's a little lake. And on the side of the lake, there's a Kadamba tree. And that tree, every day, gives two flowers to be used for Krishna's service. So Lord Chaitanya then said to Mukunda in a very sweet way, because he wants to give him some instruction, because he knows he's going back home to Bengal.
接着呢，是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，就以甜美的话语呢，开始对Mukunda说话，因为他知道Mukunda即将返回他的家乡。So
he said, "Your duty is to earn both material and spiritual wealth."
你的职责是去赚取物质的财富，并且赚取灵性的财富。Right,
because he's a doctor. So he's making money materially, and because he's a great devotee, he will also get spiritual wealth. And then Lord Chaitanya said, Raghunandan, your duty is to always serve and to stay in the service of Lord Krishna.
然后接着主柴丹念又训示 Raghunandana 对他说 Raghunanda, 你的责任就是恒常的从事于服务主 Krishna.
Yeah, Raghunandan was the boy who got the deity to eat. When he was offering the prasadam, he told the deity eat, and he wasn't eating, but Raghunandan pleaded and the deity finally ate.
Raghunandana, he
got the deity to eat.
Yes. 就是 Raghunandana 让这个神像啊最后吃掉了贡品。
Yeah, he made the offering and the deity was not eating. So Raghunandan told him, "You have to eat, you have to eat." So the deity ate.
就是一开始 Raghunanda 给神像供奉食物，神像并没有吃掉，然后最后他就哀求他，你一定得吃掉，然后最后神像就吃掉了贡品。That
deity is still being worshipped today.
那么直到今天呢，这尊神像仍然受到人们仍然受到崇拜。
Yeah. So Raghunandan was, he spent his whole life just worshiping the deity.
所以说阿古兰德呢毕生都在崇拜神像。
And so the other person was the brother of Mukunda, his name was Narahari. So Lord Chaitanya told him, I want you to remain here with the devotees.
另外一位呢是 Mukunda 的兄弟叫 Narahari, 主 Chaitanya 对他说我希望你留在这里和我的奉献者待在一起。
So there were three people and they were each given different services.
所以就这样，这三位奉献者各自又从主柴旦那那里得到了各自的不同的服务。
Mukunda was to earn money and follow the religious principles.
Mukunda 呢，他就要去赚钱，并且遵守宗教的职责。
And Narahari was to stay with the Lord's devotees.
而 Narahari 将要和主的奉献者待在一起。
I mean, it's like go for programs and do kirtan, attend the festivals, be like a full-time devotee.
那就意味着他要去参加活动，去举行 kirtan, 去举办节日，就做一个全职奉献者。
And Raghunandan, he was just to be the pujari, stay in the temple and serve the deity.
Raghunanda 呢，他的职责是一位Pujari，他就在庙里头崇拜神像。
So one person's worshipping in the temple.
那一个人就将在庙宇当中崇拜。
And the other one was doing his job as a doctor and earning money honestly.
而另外一个呢，就是担任医生，靠这个靠这个职业来诚实的赚钱。
And the other person was preaching Krishna consciousness with the devotees.
而另外一位将和奉献者们一起去传播 Krishna 知觉。
So three different kinds of service, they appear to be different, they appear to be separate, but actually they're not.
所以这三种服务表面上看好像是分开的不同的，但事实上他们彼此并没有分开。
Lord Chaitanya or Lord Krishna is in the center.
主 Krishna, 换言之就是主 Chaitanya 是在所有活动的中心。
And everyone can do different activities for the pleasure of Krishna.
每个人都可以为了主的快乐从事于不同的活动。
This is the message of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的讯息。
So maybe we'll stop here. We'll ask if there's any questions.
好，那我们讲课部分就在听到这里。接下来我们来回答问题。
Are there any questions today?
Yes. 第一个问题是 Inna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and all devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. How can a devotee who strictly follows all principles be offensive to other Vaishnavas?Doesn't following the rules purify him? Or can it be because of offensive in past lives? Inna 说 Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者请接受卑微顶拜，所有荣耀归于师了 Prabhupada。一个严格遵守原则的人怎么可能冒犯其他 Vaishnava 呢？
Well, if they're envious and if they blaspheme the devotees, yes, they could.
如果他们就心存嫉妒，或者是他们诽谤、亵渎了其他奉献者，那么就有可能就会冒犯其他Vaishnava。
You have to be very careful not to commit any offenses against the devotees. If you criticize the devotees, even though you are following yourself, You may criticize, you may be jealous or envious of someone and you criticize them.
所以要小心，不要冒犯奉献者，不要批评他们。一个人可能自己是遵守的，但是他不能去嫉妒别人。
We see the example Ramachandra Puri. Ramachandra Puri was a devotee, he was an initiated disciple of Madhavendra Puri. He had a very great spiritual master. But when his spiritual master was leaving the body, he came to him and he tried to instruct his guru.
当他的灵性导师离开躯体之前呢，他就来到灵性导师跟前，试图来训示自己的灵性导师。
His guru was feeling separation from Krishna.
他的 guru 当时就感受着跟 Krishna 的分离之情。
But Ramachandra Puri did not understand the nature of this transcendental feeling of separation, and he thought it to be material lamentation. So he told his guru, "Oh, Guruji, don't lament, you should rejoice. Think of the Brahman. Think of the Brahman and rejoice in the Brahman."
So Ramachandra Puri 就告诉自己的灵性导师, "Oh, Guruji, 您可不要悲伤啊,您要想着 Brahman, 想着饭,然后高兴起来。
Now Madhavendra Puri was far above the Brahman. He was a great devotee of Krishna.
Madhavendra Puri, 他是远远的超越了梵光的层面，他是 Krishna 的奉献者。
So this foolish disciple came there and tried to instruct him about the Brahman. It was an offense.
那么这个愚蠢的门徒，他就试图教导自己的 guru 有关于梵，所以这是一个冒犯了。
And then.He went to Lord Chaitanya, and when he came to Lord Chaitanya's place, he criticized Lord Chaitanya.
后来他来到了主 Chaitanya 的，Chaitanya 的身边，他又开始批评主 Chaitanya.
He saw there were many small insects, ants, crawling around, and when he saw them all, he said to Lord Chaitanya, he said, "Oh, so many insects are here.I think you must be keeping a lot of sweets here."
Now Ramachandra Puri 就看见地上有好多小虫子，爬着的小虫子，然后他就对主 Chaitanya 说， "Oh, 地上有这么多昆虫，你一定留着很多甜品吧。
I've heard before that you people eat too many sweets. Now I can see it's true."
我以前听说你们这些人吃很多的甜品，现在我亲眼看到了，这是真的。
So this was an offense. This was a criticism of Lord Chaitanya.
这个是批评他，竟然批评出 Chaitanya。
Actually, it's the nature of little insects that they always run around here and there. You cannot avoid it.
实际上，小昆虫、小虫子。他们天性就会爬来爬去，这是到处都有，这不可避免。
And Lord Chaitanya never kept any prasadam around; he would always distribute it.
Lord Chaitanya, 他从来不会就自己私自留着prasadam，他总是派给奉献者。
So this person, he had a habit to just go around and criticize people.
所以这个人他就养成了批评别人的习惯，他到处批评别人。
But he was a devotee. He was initiated. He had a very great spiritual master. But he could not take advantage.
She said, 她接着就说，那么遵守规则仍然不能净化他吗？ Doesn't following the rules purify him?
Well, yes, to some extent, but you have to do more. You have to follow, you have to be careful not to commit offenses.
遵守规则在某种程度上可以净化人，但是还要做更多的功课，还要小心不要做冒犯。
We can become very proud that I'm following the rules, I'm a great devotee, I'm following all the rules and regulations, I'm very advanced. And like that, our false ego can be out of control.
我们可能会因此骄傲，哦。我遵守了规范原则，我是这么伟大的奉献者，我这么进步，那么我们的假我可能是失控了。
Yes.
Or can it be because of offenses in past life, 或者是有可能他过往前生世就有这个做过冒犯。
Well, we don't know past lives. Maybe.The past life, we may not have been devotees, but we may have had the tendency to find fault with people and to criticize people. When we were reading the chapter,about cleaning the Gundicha temple, it was described about getting rid of all the dirt and the sand and the dust. So this sand and dirt and dust is like the impurities in the heart.
那么这些泥土、沙粒，还有这些尘土，就代表着内心的不洁。
And some of the impurities in the heart are things like.Finding fault with others unnecessarily.
内心的其中一个不洁就是毫无必要的去挑别人的毛病。
Yeah, if we find fault, we go just make a habit of criticizing people. Oh, this is not good. Oh, this is not proper. He shouldn't do like that. And, you know, we just criticize people. Then this is not good.
如果我们已经都养成了习惯了，总是觉得哦，这样做不好，这样做不对，不应当这样做，就这么批评别人，这是不好的。
This tendency may come. It may be there due to past life, or it may just be due to bad association.
那么这种不良的倾向。有可能是来自于前世，有可能是来自于不良的涟漪。
Yeah, if you get bad association, other people, they're criticizing, they're finding fault, they don't have any faith, they have very weak faith, and they criticize other people who follow.
就是你涟漪的对象，可能就喜欢批评人，可能就喜欢挑错。他的信心也很薄弱， 那么他就有可能就这个联姻的对象他就是本身就喜欢批评人。
We find usually the people who criticize are the ones who don't follow very well, don't follow strictly. So they criticize, they don't think anybody follows strictly.
我们发现就那些喜欢挑错挑毛病的人他们就是不是很严格的遵守然后他们就觉得别人也不是严格的遵守。下一个问题是 Danatili Hare Krishna 请问 Guru 主 Jagannath 和主 Chaitanya 前面的称呼都是主请问这两个主的含义怎么区别谢谢你明白你的莲花谢谢 Hare Krishna Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya both are called Lord how to distinguish the meaning ofOh, the Lord.
Well, Lord Jagannath is the Lord who appears in the form of wood. He's called Daru Brahman. Daru means, Daru means wood and Brahman means spirit. So the form of Jagannath is spiritual, but he appears to be in a wood, made of coming from a wooden form.
主 Jagannath 他是主的木质形体他叫 Daru Brahman Daru 的意思是木头 Brahman 是灵性的所以这主 Jagannath 是灵性的但是他是木质的形体
So Lord Jagannath he is appearing along with his brother and sister
主 Jagannath 是和他的哥哥、兄长和他的妹妹一同显现的。
And we heard Lord Jagannath, his consort is the goddess of fortune, and he lives in Dwarka.
我们听到了主 Jagannath 的伴侣是幸运女神，他的居所是 Dwarka。
But Lord Chaitanya.Lord Chaitanya comes, he doesn't come as God, but he comes in the mood of Radharani, in the mood of Srimati Radharani.
Guru Chaitanya, he is not in the mood of God, he is in the mood of Srimati Radharani.
Lord Chaitanya is a covered incarnation of Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 是 Krishna 的一个隐蔽的化身。
He never wanted people to think of him as God. He wanted only to experience the mood of being Radharani, in the mood of Radharani.
他不希望别人把他认为是神，他只希望去体验 Radharani 的心绪。
So he came to show us how we can practice devotional service to develop this mood of spontaneous love for Krishna.
He 降临就是来向人们来展示如何执行奉爱服务，以发展对 Krishna 的自发的爱。
So this was appreciated by Rupa Goswami and he described Lord Chaitanya as being the most merciful of all of Krishna's incarnations.
Srila Rupa Goswami 就非常欣赏主的这一点他称主 Chaitanya 是主 Krishna 所有化身当中最仁慈的一位化身。
That he is giving Krishna prema, he's giving the highest thing, love of Krishna on the highest platform, and he's giving it to everyone.
Guru Chaitanya 降临给予世人 Krishna prema 是最高层面的这个神爱，而且他是给予所有的众生。
So externally, Lord Chaitanya comes to establish the Yuga Dharma, which is Sankirtan.
崇拜在上，如柴丹尼降临，是为了来建立尤格达玛，就是年代宗教，也就是齐颂圣明这个年代大法。But
he also comes for a very special reason in this age, and that is to experience the love which Radharani had for Krishna.
但是他在这个年代降临。 还有一个特殊的原因，就是他想体验 Radharani 对 Krishna 的爱。
Because he can see that Radharani loves Krishna very much. She's very attracted to all the wonderful qualities in Krishna.
因为可以看到，就是 Radharani 深受到 Krishna 美妙品质的深深的吸引。
And Radharani is getting more pleasure than Krishna gets.
而且Radharani得到的喜乐超过了Krishna获得的喜乐。
Krishna enjoys pleasure with Radharani, but Radharani enjoys a million times more pleasure than Krishna gets from Radharani.
享受到 Radharani 来自 Radharani 的快乐，但是 Radharani 他体验到的快乐比 Krishna 体验的快乐高100万倍。
So Krishna likes to enjoy. He's the supreme enjoyer.
Krishna 他是至尊的享受者，他非常喜欢享受。
So he wants to have the pleasure which Radharani is getting.
所以 Krishna 就想要去获得 Radharani 得到的享受快乐。And
this is why Krishna comes in the Kali Yuga as Lord Chaitanya.
所以 Krishna 就是来到这个哈利年代，以主柴丹尼的身份降临到哈利年代。
He comes to experience the pleasure which Radharani is getting from her love with Krishna.
想体验就是 Radharani 爱 Krishna 得到的那种快乐的体验。So
Krishna is a blackish color, so usually when Krishna comes, he should be black. But we see Lord Chaitanya is not black. Lord Chaitanya is golden, and the reason why he's golden is because Radharani is golden.
就 Krishna 的肤色呢，通常是。 深蓝色肤色，但是Chaitanya的肤色，我们看到它不是这个 Krishna 的那个肤色，它的肤色是 Radharani 的金黄的肤色。
So we describe Lord Chaitanya that he is Radha Bhava Jyoti Suvalitam, that he's in the complexion, he has the same complexion, the golden complexion of Radharani, and he has also the sentiment of Radharani. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a very special form of Krishna, incarnation of Krishna.
Chaitanya is Krishna's special.
Of course, Lord Jagannath is also a very special form. It's not that Lord Jagannath is a special incarnation. Lord Jagannath is Krishna. Directly is Krishna. But this very special form of Lord Jagannath, it shows how much love Lord Krishna has for his devotees.
是主扎格纳的他显现出的这个特殊的形象，就表明了主 Krishna 对他的奉献者的深深的爱意。
Because Lord Jagannath, his arms and his legs are shrunk into his body, and his eyes are all dilated big.
主扎格纳的他的双臂、他的双腿都缩进了他的这个躯干里、躯干内。然后他的眼睛是睁得大大的、圆圆的。
Why? Because he's hearing about the love of all of his devotees, how they have so much love for him.
为什么呢？因为主扎格纳的当时正在聆听他的奉献者们对他的满怀的爱意。
And just as the devotees have love for Lord Jagannath, Lord Jagannath has love for them.
正像奉献者们都热爱主扎格纳，主扎格纳也热爱他的奉献者们。
And when Lord Jagannath was hearing about how his devotees loved him, that caused his hands and legs to shrink into his body and to his eyes to be expanded very wide.
当主扎格纳的就听到他的奉献者们的奉爱之情的话，他的腿、他的双手就都缩进了他的体内，然后他的眼睛一下就睁得大大的。
So Lord Jagannath is Krishna himself. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, we say, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahianya. Lord Chaitanya is the combined form of Radha and Krishna.
Lord Jagannath is Krishna 本人，而主 Chaitanya 是 Radha 和 Krishna 的合二为一的合并体。
So I hope that helps you a bit to understand the two Lords, Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
我希望这能够帮助你理解主 Jagannath 和主 Chaitanya 的他们的区别。
Yes, is there any other question?
有 yes。刚才 Kelly 这个不知道有没有回答您的问题，两主的含义。Maybe 刚才 Kelly is asking the Jagannath, the devotees call Jagannath Lord Jagannath, and also they call Chaitanya Lord Chaitanya. So she's asking.How to distinguish both of them are called Lord?
Well, there are many Lords.
有许多主。
The Lord is just a title of respect.
它就是一个尊称。
And so we certainly give respect to both Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So we certainly give respect to both Lord Jagannath and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Lord Buddha, there's Lord Buddha, Lord Kalki.Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma.
有主佛陀，有主 Kalki, 还有主 Shiva, 还有主 Brahma. So the next one's Wang Su Ying, Ding Bai Guru, 请问冒犯奉献者产生的结果也叫业报吗？ Obeisance Guru, the result coming from offending devotees. Do those results also called karma?
Yes. You could say that. You could call it. Well, we don't usually call it karma. We just call it offenses. But you, the results coming from offending devotees, do we call it karma?
Yes.
Yes, the effect of offending devotees, the effect of offending the devotees is it can stop our devotional service and it can take us out of Krishna consciousness even for some time. Engaging in activities which are not transcendental will certainly bring us karma. Okay.
Yes. Next one is Noble Wu, 顶拜咕噜，年老的奉献者。他就念十六圈，在理论上什么都不明白，这能达到完美吗？感恩。
Someone chants 16 rounds, but they don't understand anything.
Some old
person.
They only chant.
Well, if they're chanting the holy name, that's very good. Certainly they'll get some great benefit. Of course, we do say you have to follow the orders of the spiritual master.
而且我们确实也这么说，人应当遵守灵性导师的命令。
And the spiritual master says we should hear and we should read the books.
灵性导师说，我们应当聆听，我们应当读书。
The fourth offense in chanting the holy name is to blaspheme Vedic literature or literature in pursuance of the Vedic version.
唱诵圣名十诫当中的第四条冒犯就是冒犯亵渎基于伟达训谕写成的文献，冒犯伟达文献。
So if we're not reading the books regularly, then this is offensive.
不有规律的读书，这也是一个冒犯。
And somebody who is old, they should be able to chant more rounds than 16 rounds. 16 rounds is the minimum number of rounds. They should try to chant more.
倘若上了年纪的话，他念诵的圈数应该大，超过十六圈。十六圈只是最基本的圈数了。
So, because they're not able to do much service, they can't be very active, so they should chant more.
他们不能做很多的活服务，他们因为他们不能从事活跃的服务，所以他们应该更多的念诵。
Still, it's very nice to know that somebody is chanting at least 16 rounds.
即便如此，当我们听到某人念诵能够念诵十六圈，那也是非常好的了。
And We pray that Lord Krishna will be merciful to them.
我们向主 Krishna 祈祷，主 Krishna 能够，对他们仁慈。
Okay.
下一个是北京 Center 徐小渊 ，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Buddha 和所有奉献者。我的问题是，无论启迪与否，那些被视为 Vaishnava 的人，是因为没有冒犯的念诵，还是因为对 Krishna 的信心，或者是虔诚？ The question seems not complete, so shall we first answer the other question?
Okay.
Before.
Yeah.
Okay. 那，那对不起，我们先来看下个问题。您把您的问题完善一下，谢谢您。Galaxy， 尊敬的 Guru， 开素餐厅算是服务主吗？If we open vegetarian restaurant, is it counted as devotional service for the Lord?
Well, if you offer the food to Krishna, in other words, you prepare the food according to the standards of devotional service, and the people who are cooking, they should be qualified Brahmins, and they should cook for Krishna. They should cook purely, and you should offer it before you serve it in the restaurant.
那么就是这些食物必须得到供奉，他们要按照奉献服务的标准去做，而且做这些食物的人是有资格的，合格的婆罗门，是为了主 Krishna 做的。那么，而且是要纯粹的去做。然后去供奉，这样可以算。
Yeah. Prabhupada understood that running a restaurant would be a nice way for householders to maintain themselves.
这个帕帕说，那么就是，开办餐厅是居士们维生的一个很好的手段。
Yeah, that they can have a restaurant and they can cook there for Krishna and they can also preach to the people who come. It's nice if you make enough money, then you can use the profits to help to make a nice temple for Krishna.
如果能赚到钱，然后把这钱用来为 Krishna 开庙，就是非常好。
Sometimes we put books there. We have a restaurant. We will put books on the table. Then people will come to the restaurant. They can pick up the book and read the book.
有时候我们就把书放在这个餐。就是饭店餐厅的桌子上，人们来吃饭，他们就会拿起这个书来读书。
And then we also invite people come. We make cooking classes, and people can come and learn how to cook vegetarian.
然后我们也会举办烹饪课，教人们来，邀请人们来学习怎么烹饪素食。
So it's a nice occupation for devotees to do.
所以对于奉献者来说，这是一个很好的职业。
So yes, it helps. It encourages our devotional service.
所以呢，开办素餐厅，那么对于我们的奉爱服务来说是有帮助的。
Yeah. You do it for Krishna, right? You have a restaurant, you do it for Krishna. What all that you do, all, offer and give away, you do it for Krishna. So working for Krishna. So the consciousness should be there that I'm working, I'm running this restaurant for Krishna, for the pleasure of Krishna.
Okay. 下一个是潘彻他的吧, Prabhu, 明白, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj. 是这样，就是北京西好院他的一个问题，他下面又重新重复了一下。他大概的问题的意思就是说，要问，即使不管启迪还是没启迪，什么样的人是被称为是Vaishnava，举出来，类似的这种情况，就是因为他没有冒犯的念诵啊，还是因为他对这个Krishna直觉虔诚活动，还是其他的什么原因，我们把这些人称为Vaishnava。
Yes, well, it's right. Somebody may be initiated, but they may not be very much in Krishna consciousness. Although they're initiated, they may not be practicing very strictly, and they may not have much faith in Krishna.
是的，某些人他们虽然已经得到启迪了，但是他们并没有很强烈的Krishna直觉。
And somebody else may not be initiated, but they may be very serious in chanting. And they may do a lot of chanting, that's important.
他们也许就念诵很多，这一点很重要。嗯，We said
you may not be initiated just now, but in the future you should get initiated.
但您可能现在还没有得到启迪，但是将来应当得到启迪。So
you're not wasting your time. You're preparing for the initiation.
你也没有浪费时间，因为您在为启迪正在准备。And
the service which you do before initiation will benefit you once you get initiated.
而且一旦您得到启迪之后，那么在启迪之前从事的那些服务都会给你带来好处。So
you shouldn't think that because I'm not initiated, I'm not a Vaishnava.
所以您不要以为我现在还没有启迪，所以我还不是一位Vaishnava.
As soon as you start to chant the holy name, you become a Vaishnava.
一旦您开始唱诵了圣名，您就是一位Vaishnava了。
Yes.
下一个是。 看着他的吧，阿布明白Maharaj，为什么说一个崇拜神像，但批评奉献者的人是三流奉献者？批评指责孤儒会有什么后果？看着他的吧， Prabhu said, obeisance Maharaj, why do we say that one who worship deities, yet they criticize devotees? They are third class devotees. And what's the consequence of criticizing Guru?
Yes, well, they're worshipping the deity, but they don't have respect for Krishna in the heart of other people.
他们虽然崇拜神像，但是他们并不尊重居住在别人内心、其他生物内心中的主 Krishna.
So, because they... That's why they're considered third class.
就是因为这个原因，他们被
They only see Krishna in the deity. They don't see Krishna in the hearts of all the people. And if somebody is criticizing the spiritual master without any proper justification, without any good reason, they're criticizing the spiritual master, then that's very bad for their spiritual life.
倘若一个人没有任何理由，没有任何原因，也没有得到任何的，嗯，核实就批评灵性导师，那么对他的灵修很不好。
He's like a resident in hell.
就好像他是地狱的居民。
Uh-huh.
嗯，下一个是真真。
Yes.
Hare Krishna. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj， 想要和别人顶拜您甜美莲花寺顶拜所有奉献者想要和别人建立好的情感关系，当没有达到的时候，或者结果和自己想的不一样，别人可能并不像我想的那样对我，或者像我对他那样，就会特别心痛。这是心层面的愿望吗？总是想要好的情感关系，很容易依赖。 怎样面对这样的自己？什么样的心态是正确的心态？应该怀着什么样的心态和别人交往呢？ Hare Krishna, obeisance Maharaj. Obeisance to lotus feet. If we want to establish good relationship, good feelings with others, and when it is not to our expectation, or the result is not as good as what we think. The others treat me, it's not like I treat others. I will feel very sad and sorrow. Is this the desire in the level, in the mental level? I always desire good emotional relationship. I am inclined to depend on others. How can I face I myself? What's the right mood to deal with others?
Well, the right mood is to see Krishna in the heart of everyone.
正确的心态是看见每个人内心的 Krishna.
And don't be too much attached to trying to be successful in everything.
不要依附，就事事成功。
We have to understand Krishna must have a plan somewhere.
我们必须明白 Krishna 在某个地方肯定有他自己的计划。
So we just have to depend on Krishna, see what Krishna wants.
我们只要去依赖 Krishna， 看 Krishna 想要什么。
Be yourself. Don't try to be somebody else. Just try to be who you are.
做你自己，不要去做别人，做你本身的自我。
We don't know ultimately what the future has for us. We have to just try to take advantage of every moment to become Krishna conscious.
我们不知道，最终对我们而言有什么等待着我们。我们只是利用片片刻刻的、分分秒秒的时间来具备 Krishna 这觉。
The real relationship is with Krishna. Material world, you have many relationships, many friends, they'll come and go.
真正的关系是与Krishna的关系，在物质世界有各式各样的朋友，他们来来去去。
You know, we're born with mothers and fathers, but then in course of time, mother and father, they grow old and then they leave the body. And where when they leave us, they go off.
我们出生，我们有自己的父母，但是我们父母逐渐的就会年迈体衰，最终离我们而去。
And you may get married and have children, but the children will grow up and they may go away and leave you.
您可能结婚生子，但是这些孩子长大成人，然后就离你而去了。
But the person who's always with you, who's the real friend, is Krishna.
但是那个始终跟您在一起的。 那个你真正的朋友是Krishna。
And just try to keep that relationship. Always remember your real friend.
只是努力的去保持这一种关系。他是你真正的朋友。Okay. 下一个是毛毛，顶拜咕噜的莲花族，顶拜您，如何分辨？ 是自己的缺点还是受打扰了？如何做到不受打扰，保持自己的本性？如何做到忍耐呢？ So dear Gurudev, obeisances to lotus feet. How do we distinguish whether when there are events happen, whether is this due to our shortcomings or that we are disturbed? How can we remain undisturbed and keep remain our own nature? How to become tolerant?
Yes, we can remain undisturbed and we can remain tolerant by taking shelter of Krishna, by remembering Krishna and remembering that Krishna is the ultimate controller.
我们通过脱避 Krishna. 通过记住 Krishna， 记住 Krishna 是终极的控制者，来不受打扰，保持忍耐。
And our duty is to surrender to Krishna and to follow his instructions.
我们的职责是向 Krishna 臣服，听 Krishna 的训示。
Krishna has given us instructions like surrender to him and cultivate the mode of goodness.
Krishna 训示我们要向他臣服，要培养善良属性。
When we do these things, then we will please Krishna.
如果我们这样去做的，就能够取悦 Krishna.
But if we start to be independent and do what we like without following rules and regulations, without remembering Krishna's teachings, then we are under the modes of passion and ignorance, and we will suffer.
但是如果我们独立行事，我行我素，然后也不遵守任何规则，不记住 Krishna 的教导，那我们就是处于愚昧属性和激情属性，结果就是受苦。
And the sign that we're suffering is that we start to become passionate and angry and emotional. We don't control our senses and mind.
受苦的征兆就是我们变得特别的情绪化，变得愤怒，变得特别的激动，然后我们控制不了自己的感官，控制不了自己的心意。
So we can see we haven't surrendered to Krishna.
我们就能看到我们并没有臣服 Krishna.
Okay.
下。Oh, no more questions. It says thank you so much.
Okay, thank you all very much. Thank you, Guru Mani, for translation. And thank all the devotees for their participation and questions. And we'll meet tomorrow. Srila Prabhupada.
No, 那非常感谢大家的聆听，明天见。Srila
Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Gaur Bhaktivrinda ki.
chapter 4. Should I ask if anyone remembers anything?